Yeah, it's by an artist called Charles Robb, who's a Queensland-based artist. Well, Charles, that's one of the great ironies. Charles the Trobe was the first governor of Victoria and was responsible for establishing Melbourne University, the Botanical Gardens, the State Library, but historically has sort of since been forgotten, really. Really asking the question whether these sort of grand statues on plinths, big marble plinths that you see dotted around cities, whether they're actually valid anymore, whether that's the way we should be remembering people. So by inverting that, he's actually undermining the role of that sort of sculptural presentation of past figures. And the work behind us is actually life-size. It's, so that's as it would be if it was inverted the other way. The other reason is Charles the Trobe is known a lot better in England. So if you're viewing this from England, you're actually viewing it the right way up. The Charles Robb donated the work to us in 2006, and it was installed in 2007, which sort of celebrated the year of the 40th anniversary of the university. So it's been there since then, and had a rather interesting history while it's been here. It looked rather interesting, just having this really bright little pink spot and not knowing what it was doing. It had sort of a surrealist element about it, which we were quite happy about. It didn't damage the work, and the wind has obviously subsequently blown it off. So now we're happy for people to get up and close and personal with it, as long as they don't damage it.